Multidimensional data commonly represents data that's been collected over multiple time periods. It can be found online at various open data sources in NetCDF, HDF, and GRIB file formats. So let's take a look how to bring this data into ArcGIS Pro and ArcGIS Online so you can get started working with multidimensional data today.
We'll start things off in ArcGIS Pro. We'll right-click on our GeoDatabase to create a new mosaic dataset. We'll give our mosaic dataset a name, stick with the default properties, and hit run. We will navigate back to our catalog and right-click on our mosaic dataset to add rasters. I'll select the raster type that corresponds to my input data. In this case, I'm going to be using NetCDF files, so I'll choose NetCDF and then navigate to the folder that they're located. NetCDF files will have a file extension of .nc. I'll then select this properties button, which will open up the raster type properties window. I'll select variables and choose the variables that I want to bring in with my multidimensional data. I'll then hit OK. For the raster processing and post-processing options, I will choose calculate statistics. I'll then hit run to create my multidimensional mosaic dataset. Once created, I can zoom out to see the full extent of my new dataset. I'll select my dataset and my table of contents, and then navigate to the multidimensional tab at the top. I have the drop-down option to choose which variable I want displayed. Once selected, I'll hit play to see how it changes over time. We're looking at mean ocean temperature over the last 10 years. I can also interact with my data by simply clicking on the map. This will bring up the query window, where I can see the exact temperature of the location I chose. It's 298 Kelvin, which corresponds to 25 degrees Celsius. Now, using the copy raster tool, I'll export my multidimensional mosaic dataset as a CRF file, or a cloud raster format. I'll specify an output location, give my CRF a name, and hit save. I'll ensure that both these multidimensional options are checked, and then I'll hit run. CRFs are the natively supported multidimensional format in ArcGIS. This means I can easily bring this data into ArcGIS Online. I'll hit New Item and choose Imagery Layer. I'll select Tiled Imagery Layer and then choose One Image. I'll hit Next and simply drag in my entire CRF folder into the dotted area. I'll specify a name along with a summary and hit Create. Once uploaded, my multidimensional data is now available in ArcGIS Online, which I can now easily share with others. That's it for this GeoSnap. We'll see you next time.